Hello children, welcome once again. Today, first of all, I'll tell you the syllabus of first, that is PE1. And PE1, you have to study chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3 and chapter 6. PE1 mein aapko chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3 and chapter 6 padhna hai. Okay children? And first chapter, second chapter and third chapter have already been discussed in my previous video. If you have not seen yet, first you go and see those videos. Then you can join me in this video. Okay children? Now, today I shall teach you the sixth chapter, that is Jesus around us. And the points to be covered in this chapter are reversible and irreversible changes, physical and chemical changes, changes when two different substances are mixed, and some more examples of physical and chemical changes. Okay children? So let's start the chapter, changes around us. Okay? Children, you can see so many changes around you. Most of the things around you are changing all the time. You can see so many changes around you. Today, this time it is daytime, and after a few hours it will be night. Now I am here, and after a moment I may be somewhere else. Sometimes it rains, sometimes it is sunny. So many changes are there. Changes in weather, changes of days and nights, changes in plants, like germination of seeds, growth, flowering and bearing of fruits, changes in animals, growth, birth of babies, changes in movement of the things, changes in the state, in the color. So there are so many changes, and if you think over all these changes, you can find out that each and every change has a cause. हर एक change के पीछे एक कारण होता है, and it is this cause which actually brings about changes in shape, size, color, position, state and internal structure. कारण की वजह से changes के जो कारण होते हैं, उसी की वजह से चीजों के shape में, size में, color में, position में सब में changes आते हैं. Let's see some examples of such types of changes. Changes in, first of all, we will see changes in shape. Okay, children? Changes in shape. Children, take a balloon and squeeze it. What will happen? If it's same the previous one, iska size, iska shape bilkul wahi hoga jo pehle tha. If it stayed exactly the same as it was earlier? No. Its shape will be changed. Iska shape badal jayega. And what is the cause of the change of shape? Squeezing. Children, if you squeeze it, it will change its size. And if you stop squeezing, it will come back to its original shape. So, squeezing is the reason. Similarly, if you take some clay, some items of soft material and squeeze them, they will change their shape. Unke size, unke shape jo honge, change ho jayenge. Okay, children? Now, let's see the examples of changes in size. Okay, children? For this, let's take a piece of paper. Okay, children? This is a piece of paper. And what will happen when I fold it? Let's see. If I have folded it, its size has reduced. Iska size chota ho gaya hai. And when I unfold it, jab isko main unfold karungi, it will come back to its original size. Have you got it, children? Ye apne Similarly, if I tear it, मैं इसे फाड़ देती हूँ, okay? मैं इसको फाड़ती हूँ. What will happen? It will become 2, but its size is reduced. इसके साइज कम हो गए. तो we have seen that children sizes, their sizes have changed. Similarly, children.
Now, let's see irreversible.
irreversible changes. Irreversible changes. Irreversible changes. Okay, children? Let's see some more examples. If you squeeze a balloon hard, what will happen? It will burst. Before time. If you tear a piece of paper, you will get two pieces of papers. Similarly, if you cook food, you will get cooked food from unknown materials. If you boil a cake, it will be boiled. It will become solid. Okay, children? And if you want to convert back to the original state, can it be possible? Kya ye sambhav hai? Can curd be converted into milk? Can, if you burn a piece of paper, you will get ash? Can ashes be converted into paper? No, children, it is not possible. Okay? If paper is torn, can you get it back? If you cut a piece of cloth, can you get it original shape? Can you get its original shape? No, never. So, children, these changes cannot be reversed back. These changes are permanent. So, such type of changes are called irreversible changes. The changes which cannot be reversed back. Okay, children? So, irreversible changes are those changes which cannot reverse back. These changes are permanent. And in most of the irreversible changes, new substances are formed. Okay, children? Now, I think it is clear to all of you. Now, let's see another point, that is physical and chemical changes. Physical and chemical changes. Physical changes के बारे में जानेंगे तो physical change, first of all we will discuss about physical change. Okay, physical changes, what are physical changes? Physical changes क्या होता है? To understand these changes, let's reconsider some examples. Examples of kicking a ball. Examples of kicking a ball. Kicking a ball. Okay, children? Tearing of paper. Tearing of paper. Paper. Busting of balloon. Busting of balloon. Okay, children? Heating of substance. Melting of substances. Melting of substances. Heating of what? Heating of substances. Okay? Heating of substances. Okay, children? First of all, let's see kicking a ball. When you kick a ball up, what will happen? The ball will go.
Thank you.
If you squeeze a balloon very hard, it will burst. But material will not change. Okay, children? Iski material mein koi changes nahi aayenge. If the molecules of balloon are the same as they were before. Jaisa pehle the, abhi bhi waise hi hain. Bas unki position, unki size mein changes aa gaye hain, shape mein changes aa gaye hain. But material is the same. Melting of substance. When you hit wax, what will happen? It will melt, but material will remain the same. There is no change in the molecules. There is no change in the structure of molecules. If you melt ice, and the molecules of ice and molecules of water are exactly the same. Similarly, if you keep a balloon in the sun, what will happen? Its size will increase. If balloon ko hum dhoop mein rakhenge, to kya hoga? Iska size badh jayega. But why is this increase in its size? Why is there increase in its size? It has increased its size because the air inside, iske andar jo air hai, air inside the balloon has expanded. There is expansion of air inside the ball, and because of this expansion, ball size has increased. Iske size badh gaye hain. Similarly, iron expands on heating. Liquids expand on heating, and when they are cool, they regain their shape. They regain their size. Okay, children. Similarly, heating of substance. We have seen the examples of heating of substances. So, in all these examples, we have seen there is no change in the internal structure. Molecules of the substance before and after the change remain the same. No new substances are formed. So, what does it mean? It means these are reversible. This can in most of the cases, these can be reversed. So, such types of changes are called physical changes. Is tarah ke changes ko kya bolte hain? Physical changes. So, physical changes are those changes in which molecules remain the same before and after the change. No new substances are formed. And in most of the cases, they can be reversed back. Wo wapas lae ja sakte hain. Okay, children? And one more thing, the properties of iron in which it expands on heating can be used in fitting a ring, iron ring on a wooden wheel. Wooden wheel par iron ring ko fit karne mein iron ki jo property jo hoti hai usko garm karne par phailta hai, usko use kiya jata hai. Let's see how it happens. How iron ring is fitted on wooden wheel. Let's see. We know that I have just discussed about the properties of iron, that it expands on heating, and this property is used in fitting of iron ring into wooden wheel. Let's see. This is wooden wheel. Okay, children? This is wooden wheel. And this space, in between this space, this is groove. Ye thoda sa dhasa hua hai. In between, the space between these two is groove. Dhasa hua hai. In between, an iron ring has to be fitted. How it happens? Let's see. Suppose, children, this is iron ring. Iron ring should be smaller than this wooden wheel, because the groove is little smaller. Groove jo hota hai, halka dhasa hua hai. So it has to be small. Or, so ring it is small, how it will be fitted on it? So we know that iron expands on heating. Iron expands on heating. So, to fit this iron ring, it is heated to expand. And when it is expanded, it is put on this groove. This groove mein isko rakha jata hai. And then it is cool. After cooling, it contracts and regains its original shape, and thus fits firmly in the wooden wheel. Is tarike se ye iron ring ko isme fit kar diya jata hai. Okay, children? Now let's see what are chemical changes. Chemical changes. Chemical changes. To understand chemical changes, let's see some examples. इसको समझने के लिए कुछ और examples देते हैं. Okay, children? Burn a piece of paper. What will you get? You will get ashes. When you burn paper, paper को burn करेंगे, paper को जब मैं burn करूंगी, what will you get? It will give ashes. Similarly, if you burn coal, it will also give ashes. If you cook food, it will be cooked. If you boil an egg, it will be boiled. It will become solid. It will taste differently. Similarly, if you make curd from milk, what will happen? Can it be converted into milk? No. Can ashes be converted into paper? Can ashes be converted into wood? Can you convert cooked food into raw food? No. Can you convert curd into milk? Can you convert chapati into flour? No. So in these changes, we have seen that this cannot be reversed back. इसको वापस नहीं किया जा सकता है. There is a change in molecular structure. We suppose children, animals and plants take food to grow. You already know. Plants and animals take food. Animals take food to grow. And in growth, what happens? New cells are formed. Okay. Animals and plants take food and result is new cells. Molecules of food and cells are same. Are the molecules of food and new cells same? No. After being processed, new substance is formed. And this substance cannot be reversed into food. So in all these changes, we have seen children, these changes cannot be reversed back. In all the changes, new substances are formed. There is change in the molecular structure. These changes are permanent. So such type of changes are called chemical changes. What is it, children? Chemical change. So we have seen children, in all these changes, new substances with different properties are formed. A chemical change occurs when there is a chemical reaction between the substances. In chemical reaction, substances react to form a new products. Suppose children, A and B are two substances. And there is a chemical reaction between these two substances and a new substance is formed, that is C. For these substances which actually react to give new substances are called reactants. In this equation, these are called reactants. What are these? Reactants. And the product is called, and the new substance is called product. Okay, children? So, what we have seen in chemical changes? Chemical changes are permanent, they can never be reversed back. In chemical change, new substances with different properties are formed. There is change in molecular structure. Okay, children? Children, we will continue this chapter in the next video. That's all for today's class.